welcome everyone to the closing session for this year's 2020 Postgraduate Research and Innovation Symposium. We've had a very, very exciting 2 days over these last 2 days of PRIS, and I'm sure a lot of you were eagerly awaiting what to expect over these 2 days, and now that it's over, you know what to expect from an online event. Thank you for joining us for this last session, and in the session we're going to announce the prize winners. But before this, I just want to give you a brief overview of some of the highlights that happened over the past 2 days. We've had Prof. Karim, who's enlightened us with his talk on the issues of vaccines and the second surge. And this is appropriately timed as our country enters into the second surge. And KwaZulu-Natal, especially, we can see on the verge of having the second surge going into the Christmas season. This talk was very well received, and we had over 400 participants enter this talk. I was watching the number of attendees go up as the talk was going on, and I just saw people keep on joining this session. It's been over the last 2 days. I mean, this talk was just yesterday around 9 o'clock. And since then it's been publicized both on radio and television. So if you haven't seen it, you can catch the video on our PRIS website. So ladies and gentlemen, students and academics and our partners from industry and government, welcome to this session. Over the last 2 days, we've watched our participant numbers rise from about 300 to 939 participants. And I'm sure everyone will agree that this is very comparable to participants in an international symposium. So well done to everyone that participated, and you deserve a round of applause wherever you are. Our students' talks have really been of the highest quality, and I am most certain that they can hold their own against the best in the world. Their presentations were very well presented, their slides were very clear, the students spoke very knowledgeably and confidently, and they've really shown that they're leading the way in South Africa and on the continent. In fact, many of our speakers were from other countries on the continent. This is a far cry, and looking at their presentations, it was a far cry from my overhead transparencies that I used as a PhD student when I was presenting, you know, in the late 1990s, we used overhead transparencies. And then I think the highlight of our talks was introducing animation by pulling a page down a transparency slide. So very well done to all the speakers. I'm very impressed by all the different pictures that you've shown on your slides, the way you presented it, how clear they were, and how you could actually make the science that we are doing in our university reach a wider audience. So well done. All speakers of both the oral and the flash presentations, you really deserve a round of applause. You can give yourselves a round of applause wherever you are, and in the chat you can congratulate each other as well. The judges' tasks were very, very difficult during this time, and I would have hated to be one of the judges in these sessions. The flash presentations are also something new. I was a bit apprehensive about this, but the students have done amazing. I first saw this idea when I attended a conference in Mumbai, India in 2016, and people were starting to do this. And I always wanted to try it out at UKZN. And I must say, it worked like a charm. It worked very well. And I'm sure that's something that we're going to have going into the future. A lot of you will know when you go to international conferences, you take all your time and effort to prepare a poster, and then you're pushed in a dark alley somewhere or the back of the room where no one actually passes by and read what's going on. So to have these flash presentations and give you your 5 minutes of fame is really a good idea. And I dropped in on each of the sessions, and I'm glad to say that you've done simply amazing. So I think we've actually achieved our aim. You know, yesterday I was interviewed by one of the radio stations, and they asked us what our aim was. And I said it was to showcase the research that we're doing there. So we've achieved our aim, which was to allow students to showcase their research, show South Africa, Africa, and the international community what part we are playing in solving the world's problems and highlighting our efforts to making the world a better place for all. So well done again to everyone involved. I'm now going to hand you over to Professor Albert Modi, who's going to make some closing remarks.
Ladies and gentlemen, colleagues, for me, there's no more exciting moment than the one when I have to thank people at the end of this symposium. To many people, this is an ordinary symposium, but to us, it's a very special moment because it is a time when our students get a chance to expose themselves to their colleagues, but they also expose themselves to people who are researchers, people who are coming to give them constructive criticisms about the work that they do. The confidence that they show is amazing. But this year was even more amazing to me because to the world, to the University of KwaZulu-Natal and to this college, this was a very difficult year. For this symposium to succeed, you need a strategic plan. And COVID-19 year has been successful mainly because people have got a plan to succeed. I'm very confident that we succeeded. In fact, I'm 99.9% confident that this symposium was more successful than the ones that we've had in the years before it. It was successful mainly because of the support that we got from the supervisors of the students, the leadership of our College Dean of Research, Professor Neil Kobenali, who was able to get together and lead the college people, the academic leaders of research in all our schools, the administrative support that he managed to get through his leadership skills. It was amazing also that this year, unlike other years, we were able to have an online judgment system that was developed by the School of Maths, Stats and Computer Sciences. Of course, they worked very closely with ICS. We thank you very much, colleagues, for that success. I must say that you have exposed yourselves, students, to the challenges. But I'm confident again that you've learned a lot. You are now going to go back. You're going to finalize your thesis. You're going to finalize your papers for publications. And in this college, we've taken a decision a long time ago that we do not compromise on the quality of our research. I am sure that the results of this symposium are not going to end here. They are going to be published in high international level journals. This is what we do in this college. We publish our research. The results are going to go into your thesis that are going to be given high credit. That is going to contribute to the successful careers of our students. It is amazing every year that we get stories that are emanating from this symposium from students who get high-level awards. I would like to thank you, colleagues, for supporting this symposium. But above all, I cannot overemphasize my gratitude to the many funders and other people who come here to show and expose what is happening in their industries so that we can learn from them. Continue to believe in UKZN. Continue every year to come and fund our research and exhibit in our research symposium. Thank you very much, and I look forward to many, many more successful years.
Thank you, Professor Modi, for that. Professor Modi is the Deputy Vice Chancellor and Head of College, and he's been very supportive in this event. He's also supported all the research endeavors in the college, and I'm very thankful to him for his leadership and giving me the room to run with my research ideas in the college. So Professor Modi, on behalf of all the organizers, we are deeply indebted to you and thank you for your support. I'm now going to give the vote of thanks before we run into the prizes. An event of this nature would not be possible without the support of the various role players. And these include the overall planning committee, that have done a tremendous job in all of these preparations. We've had countless meetings. We've met sometimes a weekly basis and sometimes after hours. So it's a job well done, and I'm glad that everything went off without a hitch. So well done to the organizing team. Secondly, the Moodle committee coordinated by Mr. Edgar Jamberi and his team, very well done to all of you. We used a new system this year where we recorded marks onto a Moodle system. And thank you to your team and for all the meetings that you had during this time. We really appreciate it. The technical committee was coordinated by Musa Antuli and Sashlin Giraj. And I know they had sleepless nights thinking about these 2 days. So thank you, Musa and Sashlin, for all the work that you have done. It's not gone unnoticed. Then the ICS support committee, coordinated by Vasu Chetty and Mpumi Kumalo. Thank you for all the support that we've received from ICS. And for the ICS continued support provided by Mr. Ray Mahajur and Abdullah Sharif, we thank you for all that you've done toward this event. The management of CAS, who secured funds for the event. An event like this is not possible without some financial contributions. So to the management of CAS, a very heartfelt thank you. And we look forward to your contributions for further events that are going to happen. To all the chairs, the co-hosts and judges in each school, both internally and externally, who have taken the time to assist with assessing the presenters, our heartfelt thanks go out to you. It's not been an easy job, especially with all the presenters presenting at such a high level. So thank you for your contribution. To the central public relations team, which included the audiovisual coordinated by James Niker, the media office and the website division, a very big thank you to you. James produced Prof. Karim's video in record time yesterday, and your team is just amazing. So thank you for this as well. To the discipline of computer science, with the assistance of Professor Celestina Variri, Soren Greenwood, and Garth Combrick, who provided the venue and equipment for hosting the 2-day event, a heartfelt thanks go out to you. And the public relations team, coordinated by Dr. Sally Frost and her team, namely Lina Rajpal, Samantha Ngongo, Nzamasi Shloba, Londeka Zondo, Moira Bolton, Christine Sunard, Asok Raja, Sane Mishlasi, and Gakina Ndamasi. Thank you for all the hard work that you've done throughout the last couple of months or so preparing for this event. I can't thank you enough for all that you have done. You've done an amazing job. Although we had a very unprecedented 2020, industry representatives still managed to dedicate time to the session where they delivered informative presentations to both UKZN staff and students in our session 6. This session 6 recording will be made available on the PRIS website. So if you haven't had a chance to have a look at our industry partners, you can do so on our PRIS website. And finally, I want to emphasize the importance of our industry partners who still managed to fund the event despite the economical impacts of COVID-19. As a show of appreciation, I would like to mention these partners. They are Tucana, Amazon Web Services, Anton Parr, Elsevier, Eskom, First Technology Group, Inkaba Biotech, MTN, the South African Council for Natural Scientific Professions, Thermo Fisher Scientific. Thank you for all the contributions that you have made. You have actually made a difference to the lives of our postgraduate students. And I've saved the best for last. This event would not be possible without the dedicated efforts of the main organizer of PRIS 2020, Mrs. Lina Rajpal. She's been slowly working behind the scenes, and you probably see my face a lot, but she's the one been doing all the work. She had a difficult job of organizing a digital event this year and had to handle the assembly of an entire network of teams in order to pull it off. A passion for research and building relationships with stakeholders is echoed in her work. She still managed to secure sponsorships this year, despite companies trimming as part of their COVID-19 response. She's an invaluable asset to the college with an unparalleled ability to bring the university and industry together. We are grateful to Lina and her team for helping Chris to grow from 300 attendees to now 934 attendees. So very well, Lena, very well done, Lena. A heartfelt thanks go out to you. You're an amazing person and you've done an amazing job this year. So now the time that you've all been waiting for, we now move on to the prize giving ceremony. And I'm going to start with the CEES oral presentations. The third prize is a Seagate 2 terabyte external hard drive and Remax outdoor Bluetooth speaker valued at 3,000 Rand. And the winner for the third prize goes to Vadini Mudli, whose supervisor was Dr. S. Nkata Njoya. So very well done, Vadini Mudli, for getting the third prize. And you can congratulate Vadini in the chat function that's available on this webinar. The second prize for CEES is a Samsung Galaxy Tab valued at 5,000 Rand. And the second prize in the oral section in CEES goes to Bonga Ngobo, whose supervisor was Prof. I. Bertling. So very well done, Bonga Ngobo. And the top prize, the first prize for the oral in the CEES category, which is a Dell Vostro laptop with the i5 core processor valued at 12,000 Rand. And that i5 core processor laptop goes to Maksuda Mohammed. So Maksuda Mohammed, very well done, whose supervisors were Dr. A. Klulo, Dr. K. Chetty, and Prof. T. Mabaudi. So very well done, Maksudu, for getting the top prize in the School of Agriculture, Earth and Environmental Sciences. Well done to you. So well done to our three winners in the School of Agriculture, Earth and Environmental Sciences. You've done very, very well. The talks are of the highest quality and your prizes will be distributed to you shortly. I'm now going to move on to the School of Chemistry and Physics and the oral presentations. And getting third prize in the oral presentations in the School of Chemistry and Physics, which is a Seagate 2 terabyte external hard drive and Remax outdoor Bluetooth speaker valued at 3,000 Rand. The third prize in the School of Chemistry and Physics goes to Pinky Ntola. And Pinky's supervisors were Prof. S. Singh, Dr. A. Muhammad, Professor Holger Friedrich, and Dr. J. Olivier. So well done, Pinky, for the third prize, which is a Seagate 2 terabyte external hard drive. The second prize in the School of Chemistry and Physics is a Samsung Galaxy Tab valued at 5,000 Rand. And the winner of this Samsung Galaxy Tab for the second prize in the School of Chemistry and Physics goes to Samantha Ndlovu, whose supervisor was Professor Vincent Nyamori. So Samantha, well done for the second prize in the School of Chemistry and Physics. Your Galaxy Tab will be with you shortly. And then the top prize in the School of Chemistry and Physics for the oral presentations is a Dell Vostro laptop with an i5 core processor valued at 12,000 Rand. And the top prize in the oral session goes to Denisha Gounden. So very well done, Denisha, for your first prize. And your supervisors were Dr. Werner van Sail and Dr. N. Nombono. So well done for getting the top prize in the School of Chemistry and Physics. I'm now moving to the School of Engineering. And in the School of Engineering, the third prize is a Seagate 2 terabyte external hard drive and a Remax outdoor Bluetooth speaker valued at 3,000 Rand. And the third prize in the School of Engineering goes to Vonani Matubela, whose supervisor is Professor Akshay Sahar Kumar. And he's also the academic leader of research in engineering. So well done to Akshay as well. And well done, Vonani, on your third prize of a Seagate 2 terabyte external hard drive. The second prize in the School of Engineering, which is a Samsung Galaxy Tab, valued at 5,000 Rand. And that prize goes to Fatima Musa. Fatima's supervisor was Dr. C. Vermont. So very well done to both student and supervisor. Fatima, your Samsung Galaxy Tab is on its way to you. And the top prize in the School of Engineering for the oral presentations, which is a Dell Vostro laptop with an i5 core processor valued at 12,000 Rand, goes to Taswald Mudli, whose supervisor was Professor I. Govender. So very well, Taswald, you've taken the top prize in the School of Engineering for the oral presentations. Well done to you. Your laptop will be with you shortly. So well done to all three prize winners in the School of Engineering. You've actually done very, very well, and your prizes are on its way to you. I'm now moving on to the School of Life Sciences for the third prize, which is a Seagate 2 terabyte external hard drive with a Remax outdoor Bluetooth speaker valued at 3,000 Rand. And this prize was sponsored by Inkaba Biotechnical Industries. So thank you for your sponsorship. And this third prize goes to Mbalenchle Mfeka, whose supervisor was Dr. T. Khoza. So very well done to Mbalenchle, and you will be receiving your external hard drive shortly. The second oral prize in the School of Life Sciences is a Samsung Galaxy Tab valued at 5,000 Rand. And thank you to our sponsors, Elsevier, who's a sponsor, very kindly sponsored this prize. And the second prize of this goes to Keelan Jagaran, whose supervisor was Professor Morgi Singh. So very well done, Keelan. Your Galaxy Tab is on its way to you. The top prize in the School of Life Sciences, which is a Dell Vostro laptop with an i5 core processor valued at 12,000 Rand, also sponsored by Elsevier. So thank you very much for your sponsorship. And this laptop i5 core processor goes to Hannah Butler. Hannah's supervisor was Professor Steve Johnson. So very well done, Hannah. You've taken the top spot in the School of Life Sciences amid some very, very tough competition. So well done to Hannah, and well done to the three prize winners in the School of Life Sciences. Your prizes are on its way to you just in time for Christmas. I'm now moving over to the School of Maths, Stats, and Computer Sciences. And the third prize in the oral section is a Seagate 2 terabyte external hard drive and Remax outdoor Bluetooth speaker valued at 3,000 Rand. And this third prize goes to Innocent Mboya, whose supervisor was Professor Henry Mwabe. So well done to Henry and Innocent on this third prize of a Seagate hard drive and Bluetooth speakers. The second prize in the School of Math, Stats, and Computer Science, which is a Samsung Galaxy Tab valued at 5,000 Rand. And thank you very much to Amazon Web Solutions for your sponsorship of this prize. And the second prize goes to Menzi Skosana, whose supervisor was Dr. A. Ezugwu. So very well done, Menzi, and the supervisor for getting the second place Samsung Galaxy Tab. We'll get this to you shortly. And the top spot in the School of Math, Stats, and Computer Sciences for the oral presentation, a Dell Vostro laptop with an i5 core processor valued at 12,000 Rand. And this was sponsored by Amazon Web Solutions. The top spot goes to Olubunmi Sule, whose supervisor was Professor Celestina Veriri. So Olubunmi, well done for getting the first prize, which is the Dell Vostro laptop with the i5 core processor. Very well done to all three prize winners in the School of Math, Stats, and Computer Sciences. Your prizes are on its way to you, and you'll get them shortly. So now we move over, and before we move over to the flash presentations, just want to congratulate all those who won prizes in the oral presentations. It was a very, very tough decision to make by all the judges, and to all those presented, you all did very, very well. It's just that these three people have made an impact on the judges, and the top spot was earned by those who got those prizes. So very, very well done. I'm now going to move over to the flash presentations. And this was a very difficult one to make, because the flash presentations, as you know, it was the first time we've ever done this. And I'm sure it's not going to be the last time. So these students would have made an impact on the judges and the audience in all of 5 minutes. So that's all they had to present, some very, very complicated science. So to all those who actually put your hands up to take part in this flash presentations, well done to you. And let's see who the winners are. In the School of Agricultural, Earth, and Environmental Science, a prize sponsored by the South African Council for Natural Scientific Professions. We have a Volcano Silenco noise canceling Bluetooth headset valued at 2000 Rand. And the third prize in the flash presentation goes to Takudzwa Mandizvo, whose supervisor was Dr. A. Odindo. So very well done, Takudzwa, and supervisor, your prize will be on its way to you shortly. The second prize in the flash presentations in the School of Agriculture, Earth, and Environmental Sciences is a Seagate 2 TB external hard drive and a Remax outdoor Bluetooth speaker valued at 3,000 Rand. And this second prize goes to Chapwa Kasomo. So Chapwa Kasoma, very well done. Your supervisor was Professor H. Chimelis. So very well done. That prize is on its way to you shortly. And the top spot in the flash presentations in the School of Agriculture, Earth, and Environmental Sciences is a Samsung Galaxy Tab A valued at 5,000 Rand. And the top spot was won by Snetemba Dube, whose supervisor was Dr. K. Keister. So very well done, Snetemba Dube. You've won yourself a Samsung Galaxy Tab A valued at 5,000 Rand. I'm sure when you set your sights on presenting this flash presentation, you didn't realize that you'd get top spot. So very, very well done. And then moving on to the School of Chemistry and Physics. And for the flash presentations, the third prize is a Volcano Silenco noise canceling Bluetooth headset valued at 2000 Rand. And this prize was sponsored by South African Council for Natural Scientific Professions. Thank you very much for your contribution. We greatly appreciate it. And the third prize in the flash session was won by Bettany Adams, whose supervisors are Professor Francesco Petruccioni and Dr. Ilya Sineski. So very, very well done for winning your third prize, Volcano Silenco noise canceling Bluetooth headset. Your third prize is on its way to you shortly. The second prize is a Seagate 2 TB external hard drive and Remax outdoor Bluetooth speaker valued at 3000 Rand. And the second prize goes to Stephanie Fraser. So Stephanie Fraser, well done. And well done to your supervisor, Professor Werner van Sale as well. You've won yourself a 2 TB external hard drive and a Remax outdoor Bluetooth speaker valued at 3000 Rand. So well done, Stephanie. The top prize in the flash presentation goes to a The top prize is a Samsung Galaxy Tab valued at 5,000 Rand. And the top prize in the School of Chemistry and Physics goes to Aviksha Manga. So Aviksha, very well done to you and your supervisor, Dr. Abdul Muhammad. So well done to this team for getting the top spot in the flash presentations. A very good effort all around to all three prize winners. Moving on to the School of Engineering. The third place winner wins a Volcano Sedenco noise cancelling Bluetooth headset valued at 2,000 Rand. Thank you very much to the South African Council for Natural Scientific Professions for sponsoring this prize. And this third place flash presentation prize goes to Andrea Del Orto, whose supervisor was Professor Christina Troy. So well done to Andrea and your supervisor for winning the third prize in the flash presentations. Very well done. The second prize in the flash presentations in the School of Engineering, a Seagate 2 TB external hard drive and Remax outdoor Bluetooth speaker valued at 3,000 Rand. This goes to Avinash Maharaj, whose supervisors were Professor S. Avarera and Professor Diresh Ram Jagannath. So very well done to Avinash for winning the second prize in the School of Engineering in the flash competition. The top spot in the School of Engineering in the flash presentations, which is a Samsung Galaxy Tab valued at 5,000 Rand. And that top spot goes to Damien Anganu. So Damien Anganu, very well done for getting the top prize in the School of Engineering. And well done to your professor, Dr. M. Kaliswa and Professor Christina Troy. And I hope you enjoy your prize. Well done to the School of Engineering and the top three winners in the flash presentation. Your prizes are on its way to you, and I hope you enjoy it. Our next school is the School of Life Sciences. And in the School of Life Sciences, the third prize, a Volcano Sedenco noise-canceling Bluetooth headset, valued at 2,000 Rand. Thank you to our sponsors, South African Council for Natural Scientific Professions. And the third prize goes to Sahenjna Bantu. So Sahenjna Bantu, very well done to you and your supervisor, Professor Yogesh Naidu, for winning the third prize in the flash presentations. The second prize in the flash presentations, a Seagate 2 TB external hard drive and a VMAX Bluetooth speaker, sponsored by Incaba Biotech. Thank you very much for your sponsorship. The second prize goes to Clarissa Naidu, also supervised by Professor Yogesh Naidu. So Clarissa and Yogesh, well done again. And Yogesh, well done for your supervision of these two students. They've taken both the third and second place in this category. So well done to both Clarissa and Sahenja and their supervisor, Professor Yogesh Naidu. The top spot in the flash presentations, which is a Samsung Galaxy Tab valued at 5,000 Rand. Thank you to Elsevier, our sponsor for this prize. That top spot goes to Janaid Moodley. Thank you for your presentation. It was well received by the School of Life Sciences, and you've now got the top spot in the flash presentations in the School of Life Sciences. Your supervisor is Dr. K. Pillay. Well done, Janaid, and well done to the three presenters in the flash presentations for the School of Life Sciences who won prizes in the school. Very well done. I'm now moving on to our last school, which is the School of Math, Stats, and Computer Science. And the third prize, a Volcano Sedenco noise cancelling Bluetooth headset, which is sponsored by the South African Council for Natural Scientific Professions. You can see we're nearing the end now. And that third prize goes to Nonduduzo Mkize. So Nonduduzo Mkize, you've got the third prize in the flash presentations. Your supervisor was Dr. S. Malesi. So well done for the third prize. The second prize in the School of Math, Stats, and Computer Sciences is a Seagate 2 TB external hard drive and a Remax outdoor Bluetooth speaker. And that was sponsored by Tucana Solutions. So thank you for your sponsorship. The second prize goes to Amy Boysens. Amy Boysens, whose supervisor was Professor Celestina Variri. Well done to you for getting the second prize in the School of Math, Stats, and Computer Sciences. and the top spot in the School of Math Science, Math, Stats, and Computer Science, which is a Samsung Galaxy Tab A valued at 5,000 Rand, sponsored by Tucana Solutions. Thank you very much for your sponsorship. The top spot goes to Carla Peterser. So Carla Peterser, well done. Your supervisors were Professor K. Moodley, Professor M. Butcher, Professor D. De Villiers. So very well done for getting the top spot in the School of Math, Stats, and Computer Sciences, which is a Samsung Galaxy Tab valued at 5,000 Rand. So students, that's the end of all our prizes. You see that this year we've increased the number of prizes quite a bit, and we've had a total of 30 prizes that we've had in our in the college. And it's more than we've ever had in the last 10 years. So we've had a total of 30 prizes just for the people who participated. And I hope that this encourages participation in future years for the people. To all those who won prizes, very well done. To all those who didn't, you probably just didn't make it, but we hope to see you again next year to win a prize. So students, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a difficult year and a difficult time in all our lives, but students, you have shown great resilience and tenacity, and it's nice to round off the year with a positive symposium like the one we've just had. So congratulations to all those that participated in this symposium. You've done very, very, very well. And before I leave you, I'm sure you're tired of my face now. I want to leave you with the words of someone who was a famous singer in my time. His name was Billy Ocean. And he said, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. So students, you have done just that. I applaud you and I wish you well in the remainder of your studies. We're now moving on to the lucky draw segment, and I'm handing you over to three people who look much better than I do. Ms. Christine Sionard, Dr. Sally Frost, and Ms. Samantha Ngongo.
Thanks, Neil. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the lucky draw segment. I know that this is a part that many of you have been waiting for eagerly, but I'm going to go straight into it because our first award is 5 goodie bags. They contain a USB license disc holder, and this is sponsored by Eskom, who has given a great deal of support to students. And so I'm going to ask Dr. Sally Frost to please select 5 numbers between 1 and 200. And let's hope you were in the first 200 to register. And Sally will call out those numbers and we will announce who those winners are. And we will be in contact with winners to tell you how you'll be receiving your prizes.
Thanks, Christine. The first number is number 2. Sam, are you going to say who the winner is? Number 2.
Number 2 is Bea Leroy McCabe from Facebook, who's joining us via Facebook.
Okay, thank you. My next number is number 27. Number 27.
Number 27 is Kaeli Shelakim Teta, who's also joining us from Facebook.
The next number is number 28. 28.
28 is Shahidul Islam, who's joining us via the webinar.
Aha, Prof. Islam. The next number is number 35.
35 is Muhammad Mustafa.
And the final number is number 197, 197.
197 is Seshni Govinda.
The next set of lucky draws are sponsored by First Technology Group, and they are one of UKZN's technology and computer suppliers. And these lucky prizes consist of a handheld scanner with a bag and a keyboard with a wireless mouse. So Sally, I'm going to ask you to pick 2 numbers between 201 and 300.
My first number is number 201.
201 is Yotesha Dava.
And my second number is number 299.
299 is Ursula Schala.
The next prize is 10 HP headsets, which are sponsored by UKZN's ICS department. So thank you to Ray Mahadea. And ICS supports PRIS every year. And so I'm going to ask Sally to pick 10 numbers between 301 and 600.
Okay, the first number, Sam, is number 303
is Veena Rupa.
The next number is number 400.
Number 400 is Vusmo Zinduli.
The next number is number 422.
422 is Issa Bertling.
The next number is number 457. 457.
457 is Shakira Sheikh.
The next number is number 500.
Number 500 is Melissa Govinda.
The next number is number 502.
502 is Fatima Musa.
The next number is 515.
515 is Ntuba Nkasi.
The next number is 544.
That's Adironke Kudra Kudri Abojukoro.
Well done, Sam. The next number is number 572. 572
is Libosta Mwadzigeni. Libosta Mwadzigeni.
And the final number is number 590. 590.
That's Amy Boyson.
Thanks, Sam. Christine, back to you.
Thanks so much. The next prize is two goodie bags that have a mouse pad, memory stick pen, and applied renology book. And that is sponsored by Anton Parr. Anton Parr develops, produces, and sells analytical instruments. So Sally is going to draw two numbers between 601 and 700.
Okay, my first number is number 601.
601 is Gregorius Mungan.
And my other number is number 700. 700.
Number 700 is Asandangwebo.
The next prize is a 1,500 Rand exclusive books voucher, and that is sponsored by Thermo Fisher. Thermo Fisher provides scientific instrumentation, reagents, and consumables, as well as software and services to healthcare, life science, and other laboratories. So Sally, again, a number between 601 and 700.
And the number I've selected is number 650. 650, Sam.
650 is Bongseni Tolo.
Well done. Thanks, Sam and Sally. The next one we are moving on to is the MTN-sponsored Lucky Draw, which is a backpack with a 7-inch Huawei. MTN is Africa's premium telecommunications network provider. So Sally, if you could select one lucky number between 601 and 700.
The number selected is 699.
That's Kiola Ngosa.
The next set of Lucky Draws were sponsored by Tucana. They are one of the biggest supporters of our computer science and computer engineering students. They are a leading independent provider of insurance software solutions to the financial services sector. And the prize is a 1 terabyte hard drive, a 2 terabyte hard drive, and a tablet. So three different prizes. So Sally, if you could select three numbers between 701 and 939.
Okay, the first number is number 705.
That's Kulile Nzimande.
The next number is 710. 710.
710 is Pumelela Peace Mwelasi.
And the final number is number 852, 852.
852 is M.M. Viela.
Christine? Great, congratulations to all of you. And then this brings us to the moment we've all been waiting for. This is our grand lucky draw prize. It is a Dell Latitude 3190 N4120 non-touch laptop sponsored by the college, 11.6 inch. So this is from the College of Agriculture, Engineering, and a number between 1 and 939.
The number I have drawn is number 525. Sam, 525.
So, 525 is, wait for it, Olutosin Taiwo.
Thanks, Sam.
Congratulations to you. We'll be in touch with all of our prize winners about how you will receive your prizes. And then we would just finally like to thank all of our lucky draw sponsors. So that's Eskom, RCS Technology, Anton Palm, Thermo Fisher, MTN, and Tucana. And then finally also the College of Agriculture, Engineering and Science for these awesome prizes. So enjoy them, everybody. And I'm going to hand over back to Neil. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Christine, for doing that. And well done, Adiolo. It's been a good 2 days, and I'm sure you don't regret joining us for these 2 days. So very well done to you and to all the Lucky Draw prize winners. That's our way of saying thank you for joining us in these 2 days and listening to all our talks and our research that's being carried out in the college. So ladies and gentlemen, students and academics, industry partners, people from government, we've actually come to the end of a very glorious 2 days. I'm glad that we've decided to go online and have our PRIS event online. You've really done us proud. And if I don't see all of you again before the end of the year, I want to wish you a very, very happy festive season, a happy Christmas and New Year. Please keep safe, and I will see you sometime in 2021. So goodbye, everybody, and thank you for a lovely event. Bye-bye.